Thank you. There they are.
Which must mean they took out every one of the exorcists who went after them.
Hey, I told them not to bother. Now how did that sword of yours turn out? Fine. I'll find out myself.
Rokuro, we can handle the exorcists. Go and find your victory.
Thanks.
All right, let's get down to business. Better not die too quickly on me. I want this to be fun. Come on, bro. Don't hold back.
Shut up. Don't play games with me.
Take a good look, because they're going to cut you down.
Yeah, that's right. Get into it. Keep it up. I love it.
Put up a good fight, I'll give you that. But you're a frickin' demon. Shouldn't you bring more to the table than pretty damn good Rangetsu style? You don't have what it takes to win against the rightful heir.
Don't count me out. Just yet.
I've got something to show you!
Now that was clever! Giving up one of your own hands to go for my neck! If I was just a second slower, I'd be dead now. I like it. This is what I've been looking for. All right, let's call it good here. Listen up! If you all want any hope of beating me, come find me once you're more skilled and better armed.
I'll cut you down. No matter how many times I lose. No matter how many years it takes.
There we go. That's the face I'm looking for. So vicious. It's perfect.
What is wrong with him?
Shouldn't you be worrying more about your own skin? The entire Abbey knows by now that you're a traitor.
That guy, he was really strong.
Yeah, he was. They all are.
But we will beat him if we must. No matter what it takes.
The Von Eltius here.
Let's get going.
Please, take me with you. I'll make a sword that surpasses Stormhowl yet. I know I will. But for another blade to beat Stormhowl, its wielder must be a swordsman of unmatched skill.
Hey, Aizen. Got any room on this pile of wood scrap for a suit of armor?
If not, make someone wear it.
Works for me. You heard him, Kurogane.
Many thanks.
Okay, we're off to find Grimoire and decipher the book. You know where we're going, right, kiddo?
Yeah. We're headed for the Isolde Archipelago in Southgand. Velvet's demon hand. It's such a mysterious weapon. I can only imagine how much of a threat it will become to the Abbey. This calls for a clear-headed breakdown of everything I know about it so far. It changes shape in a flash, and could devour most anything. How must that feel, to devour something with your hand like that? But it doesn't devour the bandages that cover it up. Maybe they're protected with some sort of special art? Likewise, the rest of her outfit can't be ignored. One would think she wouldn't want to wear such ragged clothing, yet she clearly has no inclination of buying something new. I suppose that could be taken to mean she has some sort of attachment to it. But that top is really big for her. Like it was made for a man! Maybe she wears that outfit in memory of someone important to her. I'd better not touch it then. I know I may not look it, but I really am good at sewing. Maybe I should suggest mending her clothes rather than outright replacing them. On the other hand, that fabric looks like it would be hard to push a needle through. I could be in over my head. But the tougher the fight, the more I get fired up! Of course, Lord Artorias would probably scold me if he heard me talking like that.
Who'd scold you for what now?
Well, I was thinking about sewing! I mean, your clothes, they're all beat up, and I thought that if I offered to mend them for you, you'd probably scold me, wouldn't you?
You'd mend my clothes? Have they been worrying you that much?
I mean, not like constantly or anything. It just crosses my mind from time to time.
Are you good at it?
Yes. I'm told I come across as awkward sometimes, but if nothing else, I'm good with my hands.
I see. All right. If I ever need it done, I'll come to you.
Good. Just leave it to me.
Are you feeling all right? You're really sweating. The heat and the cold doesn't bother me at all. But you're a human, so you need to take care of yourself. And if you keep soaking in your own sweat, you'll catch a cold. Besides, I don't imagine it feels that great. You should keep washing and bathing on your own schedule. Like however you did before falling in with us. Just let me know and I'll make it work. Because the guys aren't considerate enough to stop and ask you if you need to.
Sure. All right. Thanks. That was a surprisingly normal thing for her to say. I probably shouldn't bother with her clothes for now. We girls have to be considerate of each other.
Oh. So, you guys made it. Whatever happened to that Swordbreaker?
He's been dealt with.
What are you doing here?
After everything you said to me, I had a change of heart. I quit banditry. Thank you.
I'm glad you listened to reason. What do you plan on doing from here on out?
I'm heading to the capital. I plan on opening a restaurant for bandit cuisine.
Bandit cuisine?
Yeah. You get your hands on all sorts of food as a bandit. You gotta use what you have and still make a tasty meal. Like a wild mushroom omelet minus the eggs. Or highwayman's stew. It's like a hunter's stew, but, you know, made by bandits.
That sounds somewhat improper, actually. But I'd still love to visit after you open.
Really? All right. I'll be an upright citizen in no time. Maybe even the kind of man you'd consider spending some time with.
I'm rooting for you.
Hey, were you actually listening to him?
Of course I was. It's wonderful he's turned over a new leaf.
Hey, you there. That's one impressive sword you got.
You know a lot about swords?
I'm a novice swordsmith. Been at it for 20 years. Now I'm finally able to make a blade worthy of the name.
20 years? And still just a novice?
It's a competitive world out there for a swordsmith, especially here on this island.
But I heard many swordsmiths have given up. There's less ore around nowadays, and swords don't work against the demons.
True, swords are useless against demons. Unless it's an exorcist that's using them. Cadnic's weaponry has always been prized in Midgant. The Abbey recognized our talents, and now, business is booming. All the smiths here are grateful to the Abbey. They're keeping all of us alive and fed.
Scout ship set.
Did you need something?
No, not really.
As you say.
Why aren't you training with two swords?
This is how I've always trained. 10,000 practice swings a day since I was a kid. I just wanted a single good swipe at Shigure. So I swung and swung, and eventually just naturally got to this point.
That's incredible.
Not really. I need to be prepared to face Shigure at any moment. But I've been thinking I should up it to 100,000 swings.
100,000? Do you have any idea how much time that'll take?
Nah.
Even if you did one swing a second, you couldn't do that many in one day.
Oh? But 10 swings a second would do the trick.
Rokuro.
Even still, I know it would take more than 100,000 swings to be a match for Shigure. Not with one sword or with two.
And you keep doing it despite knowing it's pointless? That seems a little odd.
I'm trying to defeat an undefeatable adversary. The whole damned idea is daft, as you put it. All I can do is recognize the fact and give it my best shot.
Well, that's one way of looking at it.
If only I could figure out how to stay up all night and still feel rested. Now there's a challenge I can't beat.
You need to go to bed. A lack of sleep will get you killed faster than a lack of practice.
You're right. I'll do that.
Clear way! Invigorate us! Here I come!
Come on, really?